you all in the lecture related to belt, rope and chain drive. In the previous lectures, we have seen the construction, material, tension ratios and selection procedure for flat as well as V-belt drive. In this lecture, we will solve some numericals implementing the previous selection methods which we have studied in the theory for selection of flat and V-belt drive. Let us say design of a flat belt. Let us consider the example, select a open type flat belt drive for a compressor running at 720 rpm which is driven by a 25 kilowatt 1440 rpm motor. Space is available for a center distance of 3 meters. Let us write the given data for this problem. So kilowatt to be transmitted is 25. The speed of the smaller pulley N1 equal to 1440 rpm. Speed of the driven pulley, that is bigger pulley, N2 equal to 720 rpm. The center distance capital C is 3 meters. If we convert it into mm, it comes out 3000 mm. Figure shows the schematic of the open belt drive. So let us see selection of diameters of the pulley. Let small d be the diameter of the smaller pulley and capital D be the diameter of the bigger pulley. Let us assume a belt velocity of 18 meters per second. Please note this value of belt velocity should be selected or assumed in the range 17.8 to 22.9 meters per second. In our case, we have assumed it 18 meters per second. So therefore, the belt velocity is calculated as V is equal to pi D into N1 upon 60 into 1000. So substituting the value of belt velocity as 18 meters per second, the diameter of the smaller pulley is small d equal to 60 into 1000 into 18 upon 0.21. So that comes out to be 238.73 mm. Now selecting the preferred pulley diameter of 250 mm, therefore the diameter of the smaller pulley is 250 mm and therefore the diameter of the bigger pulley is calculated as capital D equal to small d into N1 upon N2. That is equal to the standardized diameter of the smaller pulley 250 into the speed of the smaller pulley 1440 rpm divided by the speed of the driven pulley, that is bigger pulley 720 rpm. So that comes out to be 500 mm. So therefore the belt velocity for the standardized diameter values is V is equal to pi into D into N1 upon 60 into 1000, that is equal to pi into 250, which is the standardized diameter of the smaller pulley, multiplied by speed of the smaller pulley 1440, that divided by 60 into 1000. So that comes out to be 18.85 meters per second. Now since this value lies in the belt velocity range of 17.8 to 22.9 meters per second, the selected diameters of the pulleys are acceptable. Maximum power transmitted. So from the table, the load correction factor FA for the compressor is 1.3. Therefore, FA is equal to 1.3. Therefore, maximum power transmitted is calculated as correction factor FA multiplied by power to be transmitted. So 1.3 multiplied by 25, that comes out to be 32.5 kilowatt. Arc of contact factor FD. The wrap angle for the smaller pulley is calculated as alpha S equal to 180 minus 2 into sine inverse of D minus small d upon 2C. So substituting the values, we get alpha S equal to 175.23 degrees. So from the table of arc correction factor, since the value of alpha S 175.23 lies in the range between 170 and 180, we have to interpolate for the values of FD corresponding to 170 and 180 degrees. Hence, interpolating, we get the value of FD as 1.019. Now, corrected power. Corrected power is calculated as the maximum power transmitted that multiplied by arc of contact factor FT. So that comes out to be 33.12 kilowatt. Corrected belt rating.
Selecting a high speed belt which is a general purpose belt, the corrected rating at a belt speed of 18.85 meters per second is given as equal to 0.0118 multiplied by corrected kilowatt, that divided by 5.08. So that comes out to be 0.0438 kilowatt. Now selection of the belt. Now we have width multiplied by number of plies. This product is equal to corrected power, that divided by corrected belt rating. So substituting the values, we get this product equal to 756.17. Now belt widths we can calculate by assuming number of plies as below. So for 4 plies, the width comes out to be 189.04. For 5 plies, this width comes out to be 151.23. And for 6 plies, this W comes out to be 126.03. So if we observe this number of plies versus the width table, we can observe that for 5 plies, the width is 151.23, which is closer to the standard value of 152. Hence, we will select a high speed belt having 152 mm preferred width and with the 5 number of plies. Now length of the belt. The length of the belt is calculated as capital L equal to 2C, that is center distance, plus pi into d plus small d upon 2 plus capital D minus small d whole square upon 4C. So substituting the values, we get the length of belt equal to 1783.32. So we can standardize this to 7200 mm. Hence the specifications of the belt selected are 7.2 meters high speed belt with 152 mm width and 5 plies. Now let us see design of V-belt. Consider this first example. The following data is given for an open type V-belt drive. Diameter of driving pulley equal to 200 mm. Diameter of driven pulley equal to 600 mm. Groove angle for sheaves is equal to 34 degrees. Mass of belt equal to 0.5 kg per meters. Maximum permissible tension in the belt equal to 500 Newton. Coefficient of friction equal to 0.2. Contact angle for smaller pulley equal to 157 degrees. Speed of smaller pulley equal to 1440 rpm. Power to be transmitted equal to 10 kilowatt. Suggest the number of V belts to be used, assuming each belt takes its proportional part of the load. So let us write the given data for this. So kilowatt transmitted is 10. Speed of the smaller pulley 1440 rpm. Diameter of the bigger pulley 600 mm. Diameter of the smaller pulley small d equal to 200 mm. Groove angle for sheaves theta equal to 34 degrees. Mass of the belt small m equal to 0.4 kg per meter. Coefficient of friction F equal to 0.2. Angle of lap for the smaller pulley is equal to 157. Please remember, we have to convert this into radians. Hence, converting into the radians, we get 2.7402 radians. Allowable belt tension equal to 500 newtons. So belt tensions, we have the ratio of belt tension as P1 minus mv square upon P2 minus mv square equal to e raised to f into alpha s upon sine of theta 2, where mv square is the centrifugal tension and which is calculated as pc equal to mv square, that is equal to 0.5 into the belt velocity square, which is 15.08 square equal to 113.70 newtons. So using this belt tension ratio and substituting the values, we get P1 minus 113.7 divided by P2 minus 113.7 equal to V raised to 0.2, that is the coefficient of friction value, 2.7402, which is the value of wrap angle for the smaller pulley in radians, divided by sine of theta by 2, and this comes out to be 6.52. So let us consider this equation as number 1. Also, the power to be transmitted in kilowatt is given as P1 minus P2 into belt velocity small v divided by 1000. Since the power transmitted is 10 kilowatt, so therefore 10 is equal to P1 minus P2 into 15.08 upon 1000. So therefore we get P1 minus P2 equal to 663.13. Let us consider this equation as number 2. Now solving equations 1 and 2, we get P1, that is tension on tight side, equal to 896.96 newtons, and P2, the tension on slack side, equal to 233.83 newtons. Now the number of belts. The number of belts are calculated as equal to maximum tension in the belt divided by allowable tension in the belt. Now maximum tension in the belt is nothing but tension on the tight side, that is P1. So P1 upon allowable tension in the belt, which is given equal to 500. So this ratio comes out to be 1.79. So rounding off to the nearest whole number, we have number of belts required equal to 2. Let us consider this second example. Select a V belt drive to connect a 15 kilowatt 2880 rpm normal torque AC motor to a centrifugal pump running at approximately 2400 rpm for a service of 18 hours per day. The center distance should be approximately 400 mm. Assume that the pitch diameter of the driving pulley is 125 mm. So let us write the given data for this. Kilowatt transmitted is equal to 15. Speed of the motor N1 equal to 2880 rpm. Speed of the pump N2 equal to 2400 rpm. Center distance capital C equal to 400 mm. Service is 18 hours per day and diameter of the smaller pulley is 125 mm. So first correction factor according to the service, that is FA. So for a normal torque AC motor is driving centrifugal pump of 15 kilowatt capacities in this case. So therefore from the table, for the normal torque AC motor and 18 hours per day duty, the load correction factor is 1.2. So therefore in this case FA is equal to 1.2. Design power. So design power is calculated as FA into transmitted power, so that is equal to 1.2, that is correction factor, that multiplied by the power transmitted 15, that comes out to be 18 kilowatt. Now type of cross section of the belt. So for design power equal to 18 kilowatt and speed 2880, we have to consider the graph of design power versus speed of faster shaft. So here, since in our case design power is 18 kilowatt, we have to draw a line parallel to the y-axis, and since the speed of the faster pulley is 2880, we have to draw a line parallel to the x-axis. The intersection of these two lines lie in the zone of cross section B. Hence the cross section of B belt selected is B. Pitch diameter of smaller and bigger pulleys. The pitch diameter for the smaller pulley, small d, is given as 125 mm. So using the speed ratio equal to 2880 by 2400, that comes out to be 1.2. The diameter of the bigger pulley, that is capital D, is calculated as speed ratio multiplied by the diameter of the smaller pulley, that comes out to be 150 mm. Now since both the values of smaller diameter as well as bigger diameters are having preferred values, these values are taken as the design values for the pulley diameters. Now length of the belt. The belt length can be calculated as L is equal to 2C plus pi into D plus small d by 2 plus capital D minus small d the whole square upon 4C. So substituting the values, we get L is equal to 1232.36 mm. Now preferred pitch length of the belt. Now from table 13.14, the preferred pitch length for B section belt is 1210 or 1370. Now since the calculated value of length of belt is 1232.36, which is closer to 1210. In this case, the pitch length of the belt is selected as 1210 mm. Correct center distance. So substituting the value of pitch length capital L equal to 1210, we have L is equal to 2c plus pi into d plus d by 2 plus d minus d the whole square by 4c. So substituting values and solving, we get the value of c as 388.80 mm. Therefore, the corrected center distance is 388.80 mm. Now, correction factor for belt pitch length FC. So, from table 13.21, for the B cross section and 1210 pitch length, we have correction factor as equal to 0.87. So, therefore, FC is taken as 0.87. Correction factor for arc of contact. Now the arc of contact for the smaller pulley is calculated as alpha s is equal to 180 minus 2 into sine inverse of capital D minus small d upon 2c. So substituting values, we get alpha s is equal to 176.32, that is equal to 177. Now from table 13.22, corresponding to arc of contact on smaller pulley 177, we have correction factor FD equal to 0.99. So therefore, in this case, FD is equal to 0.99. Now power rating of the single V belt from table 13.17, since the speed of the pulley 2880 lies in the range of 2800 and 2900, we have to interpolate the values for the power rating for the smaller pulley pitch diameter having 125 mm as well as additional power increment for the speed ratio of 1.2. Now, since our value of speed lies in the range of 2800 and 2900, for pitch length 125, the value of power rating are corresponding to 3.93 and 3.97. So interpolating between these two values, will get the power rating for the smaller pulley for the speed of 2880. Similarly, we have to interpolate for additional power increment corresponding to speed ratio of 1.2, which lies in the range of 1.19 to 1.24. So interpolating the corresponding values, we get the power rating of the belt as 3.96, which is the interpolated value of power rating for smaller pulley at 2880 rpm plus 0.50, which is the interpolated value of additional power increment per belt for speed ratio of 1.2. So therefore, the power rating of single belt comes out to be 4.46 kilowatt. Number of belts. The number of belts are calculated as P into FA upon PR into FC into FT. So substituting the values, we get number of belts as 4.69. Rounding off to the nearest whole number, we get the number of belts as 5. Thank you for your attention.